Hi, folks. Welcome to another episode of the Superintendent's View. I am Matt Carey, Superintendent of Schools of Mercer County Special Services. On today's episode, we'll be taking you on an inside view of the food service program at Mercer High School, working with Mr. D and his team to show you all the wonderful things that they do. The students will be preparing an Italian-styled meal for everyone, and it's really a neat thing that they do. You know, it's a community-based slash work-based instruction. You know, the whole goal of it is to teach students life skills and real-world skills so that they can, in turn, turn it into an employment opportunity. And we actually have a few of our students in the program that are already working in the culinary field. So that was a great opportunity for us to get in inside and take a real look at what they're doing. But before that, I'd like to bring you a couple updates of the great things that are going on in our school district. First and foremost, we have started our strategic planning process. The strategic plan will be a five-year plan for the district from 2023 to 2028. And in that, our first working group meeting was held last week. We had over 40 volunteers come in to work with us in New Jersey school boards. And with that, we did a state of the schools presentation, which I will be sharing on our website for all of you to take a look at, as well as in the working groups, we looked at the strengths and challenges of our district moving forward. So our next group meeting is coming up and we're excited for this process. And we will be presenting the final strategic plan to the Board of Education in June of this year. Just some highlights of our district. We are starting, we have begun the process for the 2023-24 budget process. So we're looking at all of our schools and our facilities to ensure that we have all of the best quality materials and facilities for our students. So that's a great process that we're going through right now. And then the last thing I'd like to mention is we hit the 100-day mark for the school year, which is really a neat time for our children, especially our younger students that are either at Mercer Elementary School or the JFC school. So 100 days is always a fun time. Hard to believe that we've already made it through the first 100 days of the school year, but they've been great days, and I am excited about the future. So without further ado, let's take you on location to Mercer High School and the food service program. Thank you. Hey folks, Matt Carey here on location at Mercer High School. We are in the food service department with Mr. Frank DiBella. Welcome to the show, Frank.
Thank you. Welcome to my kitchen.
Yeah, it's great to be here. So, you know, why don't you tell us a little bit about the food service program, you know, and how the students, you know, we were talking about how they, you know, start from the beginning and work all the way through to the meal that we're going to show off today.
Sure, I'd be happy to. Well, it's a student-led and directed program, whereas they select the menu, they pick the recipes, they select and order the food, they receive the food, and then they prepare it.
Wow.
So it's really from the planning stage through the production and then the service, hopefully learning etiquette skills on the way as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely.
And then all that good stuff, including cleanup.
Yeah, that's a big part of the restaurant industry. In fact, my first job was washing dishes in a restaurant, so I understand what that's all about. You mentioned in there, you know, the hard, and I call them hard and soft skills, you know, those etiquette skills. That's a really important part of, you know, food service and hotel, restaurant management and all those things. Can you talk a little bit about more what you mean by those?
Absolutely. Although we're always encouraging teamwork with all the students, when they are finished, they sit down for a community meal together. And we try to practice good dining skills as they would hopefully do at home as well.
Right.
That would include, you know, proper conversation, maybe not using the cell phones during that time.
Sure.
And eating properly.
Absolutely.
Everything from using chopsticks to, you know, using the proper utensils and cutting their food.
Sure.
So that they're having the best dining experience when they leave here as well.
Absolutely. So not only are we looking at, you know, career and technical education skills, but also, you know, at life skills.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And that's Absolutely. An important part of what we do here.
Yes.
All right. So why don't you tell us a little bit about what we have behind us here?
Okay. Well, the students have prepared a wonderful meal today, starting with some radiatory pasta. And would you guys like to show off what we have here? We can maybe take a peek at it.
That'd be great. We have a couple students here that are going to help us out today. Thanks, guys.
This is Josh and James. So they are featuring radiatory, and they have learned how to cook the pasta al dente. And they learn that by tasting it to make sure it's at the right, to the tooth, thickness and doneness.
Absolutely.
They've made a couple of huge pots of risotto, and from that risotto, they have created rice balls or arancini. And we have a couple different types today. They've also made a fresh meat sauce. And when I say fresh, they took plum tomatoes. They've cooked the plum tomatoes down. They've made the sauce. They've also ground the beef. And they made a spectacular Alfredo sauce to go along with that.
Wow, so from scratch here, we're not talking about ragu out of the the jar or anything.
Real
That's outstanding.
Plum tomatoes.
Yeah.
We have some mushroom Alfredo with 4 wild mushrooms coming off of the back in just a few moments. And this is a classic bolognese sauce that they've made as well.
One of my favorites.
So all of these sauces, obviously, to top our arancini or our radiatori pasta. And down here at the end, what Italian meal would be complete without some meatballs or sausage?
Yes, got the sausage and peppers and onions. Beautiful. And then the piece de resistance, as I like to say.
Classic cannolis. And we've made the filling here.
Take a look at these.
And
unbelievable. That's right out of an Italian bakery. But made here.
And then the students also learn about the herbs and all the other ingredients. So we have some fresh parsley, Italian leaf parsley, as well as some fresh basil that they've learned to cut chiffonade style or dice. So many skills involved in preparing this today, and I'm always very, very proud of them.
What a really impressive setup that you have here for the students, and learning these skills. I can't thank you enough for having us here today to introduce your program to everybody out there on the Superintendent's View, and to showcase all the great work that our students are doing.
Excellent. Well, thank you for coming.
Thank you. Hi, folks. I'm back. Kristen Taylor, our Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum Instruction, has joined us. Welcome to the show, Kristen.
Thank you, Matt.
Yeah, it's great to have you here. So can you talk to us a little bit about, from a curricular standpoint, obviously we're doing career and technical education, as we refer to as CTE, but also some of the life skills. Can you talk about the curricular aspect of that?
Sure. So one of the basic tenets of our program is helping our students achieve their level of independence, and hopefully that's something that can carry through for adulthood. And so here we're working on developing those skills in this environment that then can be generalized out into the workforce. And so for our students, that's practicing everything from our social skills, working with our peers who could later someday be skills that we translate to our colleagues, to actually the skills that we need on the job so that we can seek employment when they leave Mercer.
Absolutely. And one of the things that we look to develop within those programs are internships or community-based instruction models. Can you talk a little bit about that as well?
Sure. So we have partnerships throughout the community, and then Frank and our other instructors work so hard to form those relationships so that our students have the opportunity to go into the community, practice those skills, whether it's through a structured learning environment or through a community-based instruction, and then hopefully those experiences turn into employment for our students. They're gaining on-site knowledge, they're getting to meet potential employers, they're getting to experience what that process looks like, first time handling a paycheck, first time understanding the process of working with your boss and troubleshooting something that might have happened on the scene. And then we're able to come back into the classroom and really process what has happened and then offer support and talk through those situations so that that student might be successful moving forward.
Hi, I'm Frank DiBella, and I'm here with my assistant, Nancy Ernst, in our food service kitchen. And Nancy and I have great fun every day in working with the students in many different areas, including everything from doing laundry and cleanup to
all the way down to being their friend. No, it's an amazing, amazing program. What we do here is just phenomenal for these kids. And they all pitch in amazing. They just come in and they feel very welcomed. They learn everything you can think of. The culinary experience they're getting here is just amazing. It's a plethora of food, all kinds of food. And it's just amazing. Frank?
I couldn't do it without Nancy.
And I couldn't do it without Frank.
It's a pleasure. And every day we have something different on the menu, and the students pick out what they're going to serve. And they go through the process of selecting the recipe, finding the recipe, ordering the food, preparing the food, tasting the food, and finally cleaning up. So today is a great day. We're going to serve guests as well.
And they're very happy. And usually on Fridays, we all get together and they all hobnob and they just get their thoughts together. Orders go in from what they picked. And Then it's cook away the whole week after.
In this next segment, we have a student demonstrating for us how to make tortellinis and raviolis. He's a little shy, so he didn't want his face on camera, but he agreed to do this demonstration for us. You can see the amazing skills that he has developed in this program using the hand pasta maker. So we sped this up a little bit so that you could see the full process, but enjoy his handiwork. He's very talented. And to close out today's show, we're going to bring you some highlights from the Mercer High School Winter Show. This was an amazing show that showcased our students' wonderful talents in music and acting. And it was the first time that we were able to bring the school community entirely together in several years due to the pandemic. So it was a really inspiring and wonderful day. And a special thank you to the principal of Mercer High School, Brian Kozakowski, for his amazing piano skills. Enjoy.
With the